Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can count even and odd digits in a number. For example, I have some number here, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In this number, how many even numbers are there? How many odd numbers are there? And here, 4 is an even number, 6 is an even number, 8 is an even number. So totally 3 even numbers are there. So even number of digits are 3. And 1 is an odd number, 5 is an odd number, 7 is an odd number. So total odd digits are 3. So I need to count this programmatically. Now we'll see how we can do this. So first of all, let us see what is the logic behind this. So here, to count even and odd digits in a number, what we have to do is, first we need to have some number. Let's say I have some number, let's say 7312. And we need to take two different variables. Let's say even count and then odd count. So two different variables I need to take, and this is my number. This is my number. So every time what we have to do is, we need to extract the last digit from this number and check this number is even or odd. If this is an even number, increase the even count. If it is not even, obviously it is an odd number, then increase the odd count. So once it is done, then eliminate this number. Then go to the next level. Extract this number and again check this number is even or odd. If it is an even number, then increase the even count. Or if it is an odd number, then increase the odd count. After that, again eliminate this number. Now go to the next level. So again extract this value and check this is an even number or odd number. If it is an even, again increase the even count. Or if it is an odd number, increase the odd count. After that, again eliminate this number. Then go to the next level and again extract this number. Check whether it is even number or odd number. If it is an even number, again increase the even count. If it is an odd number, again increase the odd count. So again, it will go back and number becomes zero. Then I need to exit from the loop. So here we are doing three activities. One is we are extracting the last digit from the number. So how we can get the last digit from the number? If any number divided by 10, if I do, this will give you the last number. Basically, that's a reminder it will give you. So once you extracted the last digit as a reminder, we need to just check which is even or odd number. And again, the last digit is divided by 2 equal to 0, then that is an even number. If it is produced 1 as a reminder, that is an odd number. So first we need to extract this value by dividing this number using modular division operator by 10. And then again, check this whether even or odd. And if it is even, increase the even count. If it is odd, increase the odd count. After increase the count, even count or odd count, we have to eliminate this value. So to eliminate this value, what we have to do is we have to again divide the same number by 10. So here we need to use just a division operator to eliminate this number. To extract this number as a reminder, we have to divide that number by using modulo division operator. Okay, so these are the two expressions we need to write. So modulo division operator will give you the last digit as an output, which is reminder. And the division operator will eliminate the last digit and it will give you a rest of the number. Okay, so this is the logic which we need to use. Now let us see in the programmatically how we can do this. Let me just go to Eclipse, or currently I'm in Eclipse. So let me just create a new Java class in my project. I will name it as count even and odd digits. Count even and odd digits. Take the main method and then finish it. Now here, first of all, I will define one number. Let's say integer, a number is equal to, I will define some number which contains even numbers and odd numbers, right? So let's say 1, 2, 3, 4. In this number, I have a 2 even numbers, 2 odd numbers, right? So now I will define two different variables to maintain the count. Let's say integer, even count is one variable. Currently, I'll make it as a 0. Again, I'll define one more variable. This is odd underscore count, which is also 0. Now I'm defining two different variables to have the count value, even count and odd count. Now I need to write a one looping statement. So inside this loop, what I'm going to do is, first check this number is greater than zero or not. So if the number is less than zero, there are no number of digits are there in the number. So always number greater than zero if the condition is true. Then inside the looping statement, the first task is from this number, I need to extract the last digit. So how to extract the last digit from this number is number divided by 10. If I do this expression, this will give you the last digit. And basically that's a reminder. So I will store that value in a variable. Let's say integer reminder equal to. Now what this rem variable contains? This contains a last digit. Now I need to check this is even number or odd number. So here I will write one if condition. Here, if the reminder value divided by 2 produces 0 as an output, that means that is an even number. So here I will say I'll increase the even count. So his initially even count is 0. So as soon as reminder divided by 2 is 0, that's an even number. So immediately need to increase the even count. Even count plus plus. Suppose if this digit percentile 2, which is not written as a 0 as a reminder, that means it is an odd number. So else part, here I will increase the odd count. Increase the odd count. So this is a loop. So what we have done first time? So what we have extracted the last digit by dividing by 10, modulo division operator we have used, and capture the last digit inside this variable. Now we have again divided that value by 2, which is produced 0 as an output, that is an even number. So increase the even count. If it is not producing 0 as an output, that is an odd number. So increase the odd count. So the last digit calculated. Now we need to eliminate this, then we'll get the rest of the number. So how to eliminate the last digit? Here we need to write one more expression. Number is equal to number division operator by 10. So once you calculated the last digit, again, number is equal to number divided by 10. Now this expression will eliminate the last digit. Now the number become only 1, 2, 3. So again, it will go up a loop, and now current values number is 1, 2, 3. Again, it is greater than 0. So again, it will extract 3. So currently here, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Currently number is 1, 2, 3, 4, the first round of iteration. And here reminder will be the 4, because the last digit it will give you. And if it is a 4, 4 divided by 2, it will produce 0 as an output. So even count will be increased. So even count is 1. And here else part will not execute. Now here number divided by 10, this is a division operator. So this will eliminate the last digit and give the rest of the number. So here number becomes 1, 2, 3. 4 is eliminated. Now the current value of num is 1, 2, 3. Now again it will go up. So here this time it will become 1, 2, 3. Number become 1, 2, 3. So let me write it here, 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3 greater than 0, condition is true. Now again here 1, 2, 3 divided by 10. So this will give you last digit, that is a 3. Now remainder is 3 now. So 3 divided by 2, which is not producing 0. That means it will go to the else part and odd count will be increased. Now the odd count will be 1. Now again it will come here. So previously 1, 2, 3 is a number. So now again divided by 10, it will eliminate the last digit and rest of the number will be stored in the number. Now the current number value becomes 1, 2. Again it will go up. Now here the number value is 1, 2. 1, 2 is greater than 0. Condition is true. Now again it will come inside the loop. So again 1, 2 divided by 10. 1, 2 divided by 10 means the last digit 2 will be written. So it will return 2 and will be stored in the reminder variable. Now 2 divided by 2, again, which is 0 produced. Now even count will become 2 here. Previously it is 1, now it is become 2. So else is part is false. Then again, it will eliminate the last digit. So previously it was 1, 2. Now this time when 1, 2 divided by 10, it will eliminate the last digit. Now the number contains only 1. Now again, it will go up. So currently number value is 1. So 1 greater than 0 current condition is true. Now it will come inside the loop. Here 1 divided by 10. So 1 divided by 10, what this will give you? Only one digit we have, that is only 1. So that will give you here. And now remainder value is 1 currently. Now here 1 divided by 2, which is not produced 0 as an output. So it will go to else block and it will increase the odd count. Now odd count becomes 2 now. So again, it will execute this expression. Here the number value is 1. So 1 divided by 10, it will produce 0 as an output. Now the number becomes 0. Now it will again go up. Now 0 greater than 0, the condition become false. So by the time all the digits we have counted, then exit from the while loop. So once you exited from the while loop, so here even count is variable contains a number of even numbers, and odd count variables contains a number of odd numbers. Now here I'm printing that value. Let us say system.out.println number of even numbers. So here into print even count that will having number of even numbers, and similarly I will also print number of odd numbers, and odd count contains a number of odd numbers. Let me just capture this and put it here. Okay, so this is how we need to count number of even numbers, number of odd numbers in a digit. Now let me run this. I already hard coded some value here. 1, 2, 3, 4 I have given. So let's run this. So now it is given number of even numbers are 2, number of odd numbers are 2. Now let me add one more odd number, 5. Now we can see it will produce, yes, number of even numbers are 2, number of odd numbers are 3. So this is how we need to get the output. So what we have done here is we have just created two different variables, which one even count contains a 0, odd count contains a 0, initial values. So we extracted the last digit from that number here and check that number is even or not. If it is even, increase the even count. If it is not even, increase the odd count. As soon as we have done this, we eliminated this digit by adding division operator. It will give you the rest of the number. And again, we have repeated the loop with the rest of the number. So this loop will repeat multiple times for every digit. And every digit we are verifying whether even or odd. And if it is even, we increase the even count. If it is odd, we are increasing the odd count. So once the loop is completed at the end, we will have even count and odd count in these two variables. Now I have printed here. Okay, so this is how we need to count even numbers, odd numbers in a digit. All right, so that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.